a guy who sets goals and do you have any position?
I just like to, you know, handle business when it's time, you know, not too many personal goals. Obviously, goals to win the AFC West, you know, get home field advantage, win that Super Bowl game.
How would you assess your rookie year? And have you given Rashee any advice on how to kind of flatten that learning curve?
Yeah, you know, just any questions that he has, be able to answer them, be available for him. You know, he's a guy that I, you know, hang out with off the field, so it's been an easy transition.
Is there anything specific about this offense that maybe makes it a lot for a rookie to have to, you know, digest it all?
It's just very detailed. You know, like Coach Reed wants you to be in a specific spot at a specific alignment, you know, so everything's, you know, it might not be as detailed as the offense you're coming from. So that's probably what makes it the most, you know, complicated.
Sky, in watching you at camp this year, it looks like you're playing very loose. And just how much more comfortable do you feel maybe this time around than where you were last year as a rookie?
Yeah, way more comfortable. It's just like I got that year of experience. So I feel like certain things that I already know, like I went through a whole season, like I shouldn't have to get coached on where to align or where to, like anything that happens before the snap, I don't need to get coached up on. You know, it's more of like, how do I beat the guy instead of what route?
What are some little things that maybe Pat likes that you've kind of learned to do as you've gone here?
Just like, it's kind of hard to explain, but it's like when I arrive in certain windows or like, you know, just always being ready to break a play in the scramble drill, you know, stuff like that, just to allow him to, you know, make plays after, you know.
Can you kind of describe our early on last season?
Yeah, my coaches, they always tell me, like, listen to the words that speak to you. So there is a whole bunch of, Pat is in the huddle saying a whole bunch of stuff, but only I got to pick out what's talking to me. So you really just, as you go through it, and, you know, as you get the repetition, like, the words become more clear of, like, what speaks to you. So it gets easier as you go.
How long did that take you to understand that lingo and understand what you're listening for like these rookies too that now have to do the same as you did?
I felt like for me to understand like all positions, because it's like that for like every position, like the X, the zebra, and the Z. So for me to understand all three positions, I feel like it took me probably about like till like week four last year, week five, to understand like everything completely.
Is there something you wish you had been told a year ago that would have made it easier for you as a rookie?
No, it's kind of, you can't even say that though, because it's like you got to go through it to learn it, basically. So it's like you can take as many mental reps you want, and people can tell you everything on the sideline, but until you go mess that play up, you're not gonna really get it in your head.
Sky, there's I don't know how much you pay attention to what's going on elsewhere, but there's in Washington, Eric Bieniemy. There were some players, I guess, complaining to the head coach, he's coaching hard or whatever. It's kind of a controversy over there.
Yeah.
What was it like for you as a kid coming out of college last year with Coach EB?
Yeah.
How did you find his coaching?
It was kind of like, it was normal to me. Like, coming from the MAC, I know I had a specific, my wide receiver coach, Coach Harbaugh, coached exactly like EB. So it was like, it's always good to have those type of coaches, because those are the coaches that, like, when everything, you know, everything sinks down at, when it's the fourth quarter, game's on the line, you kind of like sink to the level of your training that he's pushing, you know what I'm saying? He's always pushing, oh, high and tight, hold on to the ball, finish, you know? So, like, yeah, Coach EB, it was kind of the same for me in college.
Hey, Sky.
How you doing?
Hi, I'm sorry, I'm behind you. How hard is it to catch one of those behind the back passes?
It's really not that hard, and because I don't see it come out from behind. I see it a little bit, but like it's the same to me. It's still spinning, so I still gotta catch it. So it ain't that much different.
You think you've mastered it? Like it can be used in the game now?
If he gonna throw it, I'm gonna catch it.
Scott, we've seen you make those strides in practice. What do you hope to make? What kind of strides you hope to make in the few reps that you'll get in the next first
just keep it rolling over. You know, just. I felt like I had a better training camp than last year, and I'm looking, you know, to have it bleed into the season.
You mentioned big or a connection that's happened to training camp that maybe wouldn't have last year that comes to your mind. Something that's happened with Pat, or you think last year this would not even have been possible.
There's been a couple plays like that, like where it's like, oh, now I know, like, oh, this is what he was talking about. like there's been a couple plays like where it's been like the exact same look as last year, but I just treated it different. I did it differently. And last year it might have been an incomplete pass. This year I catch him and can, you know, go for some more yards. So you see little, I can't tell you specifically, but
is that like adjusting a route?
Yeah, like adjusting, it's always adjusting a route. That's the biggest part of this offense, is adjusting your routes to the look. So it's definitely been plenty.
Does that feel good when that comes together? You know that that's
for sure
part of it now?
Because you get to see, like, you get, everything's on film, you know what I'm saying? So you get to see your growth a little bit and seeing, like, how much better you got from the last year.
You made some huge plays.
A few option routes, but I always felt like, a lot more here. Just, you got a lot more freedom in your routes.
I'm so sorry.
No, go ahead.
You made some huge plays at the end of last year in huge games. What does that do for your confidence coming back to your second year?
Yeah, it definitely helped my confidence tremendously. You know, just knowing that I had like a roller coaster season, and for me to leave that season with, you know, on the high that I did, you know, it gave me all the confidence to come back even better and keep the train rolling.
Madden has you rated at 73.
Yeah.
What do you think your rating should be?
I definitely need a 99. at the end of all this, I'm gonna get the 99 for sure. But I'm
in the season.
In the season, I don't know. I'm just trying to handle business. Hopefully, I can get in the 89s or something like that.
Last one.
Yeah. Good.